Hey there, Owoo folks. This is Roberta, just checking in to see how you're doing as we're approaching the end of the week. And yes, I am in fact using Screencast-O-Matic to make this video. And one thing I wanted to point out was you have to be aware of what's behind you when you're filming, when you make these videos in Screencast-O-Matic. And I'm looking behind me at the mess on my desk and realizing, yeah, I probably should have cleaned that stuff up. So my purpose for this video is twofold. One is to make the offer to come out to help you next week. If there's a day or a time where it would be good for me to hang out in a room and just be there as a resource, and anybody who wanted to come by could pick my brain or get my help in completing any of the activities, I am totally willing to do that. So if you would find that useful and you would like me to come out, just shoot me an email and let me know some dates and times that would work. I know that it could seem like there's an overwhelming amount of things to do, but I think with just a little bit of guidance that you'll find that these things don't take you as long as you might think. So please reach out, let me know if that would be helpful, and I'm happy to do it next week, and the following week. My second purpose in the video is I wanted to do a quick little walkthrough tutorial about some features in the Blackboard editor that might be giving you some trouble. And so let's switch over and take a look at that. So here we are in the text area of an item that I created, and my goal is to take this text, "What is empathy?", and to turn it into a link to a video in YouTube. So the first thing I need to do after I type the title is I've got to go and grab that link from YouTube. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So here's my video that I want to get. It's Brené Brown talking about the difference between empathy and sympathy. If you haven't watched it, it's a pretty good one to watch. And I could go up in the address bar and capture that address, but it's long and it's got a lot of junk in it, and I just prefer to come over here to where it says share and grab that nice short one. And you could just hit copy and it'll copy that address. Also, while we're here, take a look and see. You can also tell the video to delay. You know, if you want to cut out like a long introduction or something, you could tell it to start 25 seconds into the video or whatever that you decide you want to do. In this case, it's a short introduction, so I'll just do the whole thing. And we just go copy and then flip back over to Blackboard. Okay, I've got that address copied in my clipboard. So now to turn the text into a hyperlink, I just highlight the text, hit my little hyperlink tool where it says Insert Edit Link. And now I have some decisions I need to make. The first being I can paste in my link here, just right click and paste. There it is. The main thing I need to do is where it says Target, it says Open in this window frame. That's the default, and it's a really bad default. And a better practice is for all of your links in Blackboard, instead of letting it open in this window or frame, tell it to open it in a new window or frame. Because sometimes, if you don't do that, sometimes your link will just fail. It won't work at all. Okay. All right, and then go ahead and hit Insert. And you can see, voila, we have it as a hyperlink. So that's pretty good stuff. And then you would just go ahead and submit. And then, boom, 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 you can see there is my practice item with my link. So that's one way you can put a video in your course. Type the text, make it a hyperlink, hyperlink it to the video. There is another option, though, and that is to embed the video right here in this text box. And you might think that you would want to use this YouTube button right there. Truth be told, we haven't had a tremendous amount of luck with it. It's problematic, and usually you get error messages when you try to use it. So the tool that we use is this one here on the menu, Insert Edit Embedded Media. And if you click on that, you get this dialog box. And I think it defaults to Flash, but I think you're better served by going to iframe, insert it as an iframe. And then you can paste your video link in there. And you also have the option to make some size choices. I think 320 is kind of small, so I'm going to pump this up to be, I think around 650 would be good. And I'm going to leave the constrained proportions checked so I don't distort the ratio of height to width. And you can see that it automatically resizes the width to go with the height, and that's looking like a pretty good size. And I'm just going to click insert. And then you can't see it, but I have to, in the bottom right, click submit on the item. And now, as I scoochie on down, there it is. And you can see it displays it right in the frame. And he could play it in the frame. And that's all good. It looks pretty. It keeps students all. Stop. It keeps students in Blackboard and doesn't take them out to something else that might distract them. So the embedding is another option that you have, and I hope that you saw how easy it is to do. And if you have any questions about it, make sure to hit me up. And hit me up about anything in general, guys. If there's anything that's frustrating or stuck or it feels like it's too much, just shoot me an email and I can talk you through it. No problem. All right, take care. Have a great weekend, and talk to you soon. Bye.